The mission of the Michael H. Flanagan Foundation is to comfort bone marrow transplant and leukemia induction patients and their families. Through the foundation, it is our goal to enhance the patient's quality of life. So here we are, it's November 2020, and we would normally be gathering together to celebrate the Michael H. Flanagan Foundation with live musicians, tasty food, and an amazing auction, but not this year. Although circumstances prevent us from convening this year, we can still make a difference in the lives of patients and families facing leukemia and bone marrow transplants.
We've been talking a lot at the Flanagan Foundation about the fact that COVID didn't cancel cancer. In fact, now is when the patients need our support more than ever. Cancer diagnoses are actually expected to be on the rise, as many have refrained from attending hospitals and getting diagnoses over the past 6 months. And those in hope of remission due to drug trials have lost hope because many of those trials have been suspended. Hospital treatments still present a precarious situation as COVID cases are on the rise again.
Oh, that's a good one! Oh, look at it!
Mike's Foundation is one of the few places where patients and families can get immediate financial assistance.
We just can't thank the Flanagans enough for everything that they do to support our patients. They wake up on Christmas morning, they have a gift in their room, and that just brightens their day.
There's no red tape, no waiting period, just a dedicated group of volunteers that get together to Zoom, make decisions, and mail out the check the very next day.
Since 2002, we have funded over 360 grants, totaling more than $675,000 for everything from rent and utilities to wigs and infusion chairs.
100% of your donation to the Michael Flanagan Foundation goes to funding requests like these.
We have delivered over 1,200 comfort bags to patients with items included to assist them during their hospital stay.
Hospital room massage chairs to help ease the pain.
Granting yearly scholarship for our amazing oncology nurses.
Funding the renovations of the family room for the BMT unit at Tufts Medical Center.
Reiki treatments to aid in recovery.
Almost 20 years ago, we decided that my brother's illness would not define him as a poster child for leukemia. Instead, Michael's fight should serve as an inspiration, and his memory continues to guide us to help others in their time of need.
During his lengthy hospital stays, Michael often focused on the other patients on his floor. In some ways, it kept him thinking maybe about his own situation.
You can help continue his story and his caring spirit by making a contribution today. Together we can bring comfort and hope and make life just a little brighter for those patients and families that need it the most right now.
And since we can't all be together like one big happy family in what has become the strangest year of my life, we have a special virtual concert planned for tonight, November 19th, the day we lost Mike back in 2001.
The concert features some of Mike's childhood friends,
including one of our own board members, playing the music that he loved.
We hope that you will join us. More information about how to make a donation or to watch the concert can be found in this email and on our website. From all of us at Mike's Foundation, we wish you peace, health, and happiness.
Welcome to Flanafest 2020, the COVID edition. Tonight, you're going to hear some great music by some of Mike's more talented friends, and you're going to hear some amazing words from people we've helped throughout the years. We did something similar back in 2011, and it was a real good time, so we figured we'd run it back. Without further ado, let's get this thing going.
They're better left unsung. your cup be empty, if your cup is full, may it be again, let it be known. There is a fountain that was not made by the hands of man. There is a road, no simple highway between the dawn and the dark of night. And if you go, no one may follow. That path is for your steps alone.
Flanagan family, thank you for your kind welcome gift. I arrived at Tufts on May 31st for a stem cell transplant. I stayed for 16 days. The staff was wonderful. Your gift greeted me and made me feel comfortable and welcomed. I am 58 days post-transplant and doing great. I am a dinosaur, so I don't do Facebook, but I am now a fan.
This song is very special. To Mike and his friends and family. A lot of fish fans were in his orbit, and this song, so beautiful, so delicate and lovely, and I think it really embodies the energy of Mike and who he was, and just a person who wanted to spend time with you, and really there was no agenda. It was just like connection and peace. So anyway, it's called Waste.
Painter.
Christine and the Michael H. Flanagan Foundation, I just want to thank you for the grant you extended to me. I'm so grateful for your help. Without the help, love, and support from family and friends and wonderful people like you, I don't know what I would do. I've been out of work since diagnosed with AML, and no pay makes paying bills tough. SSDI will not kick in until sometime in April. Your gift will help keep me in my home. I really appreciate it, and you very much. Many thanks.
How's it going? I'm Jon Gregory. I've known Mike since junior high school, you know, very long time. One of my best friends, so I love him, think about him every day. This is for him.
My name is Dave Dobbs, same story. Music has always been a link between me and Mike, and it has never faded, not for a minute.
I'm Nathan Ouellette. Also went to junior high school with Mike. We really became good friends in high school and those first few years of college. Music was a very big part of our friendship. We used to play guitar together all the time, see live music together, spent a lot of time in Boston together and down here in Providence. And just want to honor Mike's memory tonight.
This is Alberta.
This is off of the Eric Clapton Unplugged album.
We used to play with Mike back in the day. When we'd hang out at his house in Heatherington Drive, we'd walk down through the back path and play it on the beach. So, yeah, sentimental reasons.
Thank you so much for the generosity and thoughtfulness toward me and my family as I am treated for leukemia. From a tragedy, you have forged love, compassion, and hope. There's little doubt that Michael would be proud of his legacy. Again, from my family to yours, thank you.
Great appreciation that we thank you and the Michael Flanagan Foundation for the generosity and concern you've shown us in our time of need. Your thoughtfulness has made my road to recovery easier for myself, my wife, and our son. As your foundation stands for Michael's courage, integrity, and faith, this journey has fostered ours. I'm over halfway through my treatments. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts. We will not forget your love.
Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You enthroned, waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Won't you take these open eyes and learn to see all your life? You were only waiting for this moment to be free. Blackbird, fly. Blackbird, fly. Into the light of the dark black night. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. Waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird, fly. Blackbird, fly. Into the light of the dark black night. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Won't you take these open eyes and learn to see all your life? You were only waiting for this moment to be free. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. You were only waiting for this moment to be free.
I want to thank you for the gift bag. What a kind gesture and very much appreciated. I was diagnosed with AML and I'm currently receiving treatment at Rhode Island Hospital. I'm a 52-year-old mom of three from New Bedford, Massachusetts. I am moved by the story of your son and fight this disease in his and countless others' honor. Your kindness touched me deeply. It gives me hope, not just personally, but for the human race, to know that such compassion and empathy exist in the world. Thank you.
This next song, cover that Mike and I were gonna play together. We did play together. He brought this to me, and when I was 20, we were young, oh my god, this was like 20 years ago, and I might have been 21 actually. So yeah, it's Leather and Lace. He would be Don Henley, I would be Stevie Nicks, and we played it a couple times, at least, in his parents' living room. But I know that we would have played it out had we had more time. Not to be a certain tone.
Thank you from the bottom of my heart. I am so grateful for your grant that will help alleviate some of the burden me and my family are going through. Your mission is a wonderful and compassionate way of giving a helping hand during this difficult time. There are not enough words to express how much this means to me. This gives me the hope and strength to keep going.
Around me. Everyone, I hope this finds you all doing well. Thank you, thank you, thank you for everything that you do to support us and our patients. We continue to be grateful and blessed. I think of you often, wishing you a wonderful 2020.
We're going to play Peaceful Easy Feeling
by the Eagles.
We chose this song because it's, again, a song Mike used to play all the time whenever he was sitting there strumming on his guitar. This would inevitably be one that was done, so we wanted to do this for him tonight.
Michael Flanagan Foundation, thank you so very much for the generous gift card you blessed our family with this Christmas. You're a gift to so many, and the good you bring to the lives of patients on North 8 is appreciated more than you know. You have taken a heartbreak in your own lives and created something beautiful for others. God bless you all.
Hey everyone. I'm in my bathroom. The acoustics are so lovely in here. All you singers out there know that. I'm gonna play a Talking Heads song. It's called Heaven. Mike really loved the Talking Heads. I really love the Talking Heads as well. And so do Mike's friends, so.
Thank you so much for your generous Education Advancement Fund reward. I was thrilled and honored to learn of my selection, and I am deeply appreciative of your support. The financial assistance you provided will be of great help as I pursue my nurse practitioner degree. Thank you again for your generosity and all you do for the Cancer Center at Tufts.
Thank you. Dear Christine, I would like to thank you and the foundation for your generosity that has enabled me to return home to a safe and clean environment. Being diagnosed with AML came as such a shock, and dealing with it from there has been a challenge. Having Michael's foundation behind me has been so helpful for what I have been through and for what lies ahead.
So this song was a great idea brought to me by Tyler, fellow music enthusiast, and I think it's a really good choice because I think it's in the spirit, at least the energetic is in the spirit of honoring Mike's life, honoring him through music, and this has such a beautiful feel to it, this song. And Mike's life, though fleeting, was very beautiful. It was full of joy and accomplishments and connection. He was a really wonderful person. And anyway, I also want to take a second to thank the foundation. You've raised so much money and done so much good for so many people, and I appreciate being able to be a part of this, and you know, this organization, and even just this very small way, by playing and being a part of this show to honor Mike's life and his love for music, which he and I shared big time. It was definitely a bond for us. So this song, written by Leonard Cohen and popularized by Jeff Buckley. Thank you.
And that's a wrap. Flanafest 2020 is in the books. On behalf of everybody at the Michael H. Flanagan Foundation, just want to say thanks to those that donated, and a special thanks to everyone that performed. And most importantly, thank you for supporting us and keeping the memory of this kid alive after all these years.